Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Naveen and I'm part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. We have already covered security in Bluetooth Low Energy through two Learn Technology in 5 Minute videos. In this video, we will look at how security is implemented in the mesh implementation of Bluetooth Low Energy. The first important note regarding security in BLE mesh is that it is mandatory. This is in contrast with BLE, where it is optional and left to the developer to decide whether to include it or not. Let's look at some basics of security in BLE mesh. 1. All mesh messages are encrypted and authenticated. 2. Network security, application security, and device security are all handled independently. 3. Security keys can be changed during the life of mesh network. Due to the separation of security between the network, application, and device levels, there are three types of security keys for BLE mesh. 1. Network key. Possession of this shared key makes the device part of the network, also known as a node. There are two keys derived from the network key: the network encryption key and the privacy key. Possession of the network key allows a node to decrypt and authenticate up to the network layer, allowing the relay of messages, but no application data decryption. 2. Application key. This is a key that is shared between a subset of nodes within a mesh network, normally those that participate in a common application. For example, a lighting system application key would be shared between light switches and light bulbs, but not with a thermostat or a motion sensor. An application key is used to decrypt and authenticate messages at the application level, but it is only valid within one mesh network, not across multiple networks. 3. Device key. This is a device-specific key that is used during the provisioning process for securing communication between the unprovisioned device and the provisioner. Now let's look at some security concerns in BLE mesh. Node removal, privacy, and replay attacks are of concern in BLE mesh. First, let's look at node removal. One major concern with a mesh network is gaining access to a network via a discarded or removed device that used to be the part of the network. This can be accomplished via gaining physical access to the keys stored within the device. In order to protect against such an attack, BLE mesh defines a procedure for removal of a node where the device is added to a blacklist and the keys are refreshed. This process distributes new network keys, application keys, and other relevant data to all nodes except those in the blacklist. Now let's look at privacy. Another concern is privacy. The way privacy is addressed in BLE mesh is via the use of a privacy key that is used to obfuscate the message header. The privacy key is derived from the network key. For example, the source address could be obfuscated to prevent tracking of a device via its address. Finally, let's look at replay attacks. The last security topic we want to cover is replay attacks. A replay attack is when one or more messages are stored and replayed later by a malicious device. BLE mesh provides protection against replay attacks by utilizing a sequence number, also known as SEQ. Elements increment the SEQ value every time they publish a message. A node receiving a message from an element which contains a SEQ value that's less than or equal to the one in the last valid message will discard it. Another way BLE mesh provides protection against replay attacks is by using an incrementing IV index, which is an additional value that also gets validated when a message is received.
That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.